Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another Let's Play of Madden 19 in my career, starting with Trevor Knight. Today, we're facing against Andrew Luck in the Indianapolis Colts. They're 5-6, we're 4-7. Obviously, we know we're not making it to the playoffs, but it was a good season. Trevor's learned his lesson. Maybe next year he can do better and have better offensive line, better wide receivers. Turn up the chit chat. Let's get into the game. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe if you're new. First down and 10. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And he'll wind up with about six up past the 31. And that was a good run. This was only one of nine guys start. Of over 1,000 yards in 2017. And I think you can't let him run wild here.
Well, you think 100 yards the measuring stick?
Let's hope so.
That is the threshold. You want to keep him under that if you want to play good defense.
This is Fournette.
First down.
It's a gain of four there, and it gives them a new set of downs.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful...
First down and 10 on the 36-yard line.
Keep the defense off balance.
Let's keep this rolling.
Say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
Let's keep this rolling.
And it's a short one here compared to the tight end. Stop shy of the 45. Showed off a nice little move on the play, though. The numbers for Pryor in last week's game, 7 catches, 63 yards, and a touchdown.
And that gives him 9 for the season, and I've been around the game long enough to know this. 10 is the benchmark number.
Here we go, first down.
Because that really signifies
here we go. Here we go.
And also gives you respect.
And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
Here we go.
They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Lane better.
A good run by Fournette. Now another 1st and 10. Off the bootleg. Knight sliding out of the pocket. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you
I don't know why I'm
hurrying
it up, but I guess I am.
Just the way you're supposed to. I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen.
Where did you come from? Can I have one game that I do not have an interception, please, and thank you. Like, that's all I ask. Oh my god. What the heck? Again.
Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively. Oh. Obviously, 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
But this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor?
Well, at least the running game is working.
Didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with it, but whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. It's putting the game in jeopardy.
There's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33.
Play for the defense.
Yeah. Great.
On 3rd and 2.
First down. First freaking down. See, the run is better today. Coach gave him a lecture. Saying if we don't play efficiently and start blocking more so we can get Fournette to run, they're all being cut and they're ain't getting their dinner. And then it fails right after that. I said that.
It'll go as a loss of a yard and it'll set up third down.
We think, Brady, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in the first few drives. They're not just holding the ball.
And then you go backwards.
They're doing more than that, aren't they? To get a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example.
Good
right
job.
There for the...
Did we... got a pick six.
Out comes the Jacksonville.
We got a pick six. Okay. 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 Pick six. I like it. I like it. I like it. And he's gone. Oh. If you actually caught that, which you did. But if you actually didn't go out of bounds, that could have been all the way. We could have been the lead.
Still on the run, okay. Able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down. Fournette. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby.
Nice job by the defensive front there. Another short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby.
Shut up. No
room to run. Second down and 9. Can we get the first down here? Go prior. Go. 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 Yes. First down. We're in the red zone. Let's go. Okay.
Two yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
To throw on second down. Knight, this is caught.
Let's go.
Get there, tackled down at the one. It's his first catch, and it'll be good for 15 at a first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm?
Let's go.
Starting to happen, right? You see it.
Oh, we need to touch them.
Starting to rise. I think now's a play call.
I'll even give it to my fullback if I have to. Just want to touch down. Touchdown. Yes. The fullback touchdown. Let's go.
Tommy Mohannon, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jags are able to cash in for six.
Good job. Good job. Good job. Good job. We have more passing, more rush in the passing. That's the whole point.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result.
All right, now,
negative
look at 56.
A
look
loss
at 56.
Of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Off play action. Knight. He's going to air one out. Oh, wide open. Complete.
Let's go.
Downfield, those guys made that play possible.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40.
Let's go.
First and 10.
And that's terrific.
He's a stack sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. What, he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's gonna go for it.
Looking to throw on second down. Knight. And now he'll tuck it and run. They give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
Back to throw. Knight. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free.
Really?
Brings up fourth down.
Okay. Okay. It's cool. That's cool. I'm fine with that.
Now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go.
As long as we're winning, that's all that
matters. Points on the board last time, they had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll
see. All right,
now, look at 56. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Looking to throw. Knight. And his throw is incomplete.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion.
Oh,
the Jaguars on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 10. Back to throw. Knight. And the third down pass falls incomplete. The Jaguars offense as they get set to go again. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Good guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for the runners. And let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Here's a second and five now from the 25. On second down,
there we go.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Wow.
11 yards there for Jacksonville at a first down as well.
Exactly what they needed right there because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Gone!
On first and 10. Nice. And this is Moncrief with a catch. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield.
Wow.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
All right, now, look at 56.
Throwing on first down. Knight. Firing quickly here, and that's complete.
Knock them out.
The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44.
I didn't see them.
Now that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there because trying is one thing. We can see that just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try to pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
Alright, trying to get close. So, we call another timeout.
Caught him out.
timeout. Call timeout. Kick a field goal. 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 And then they kicked the field goal as well. But it's okay.
The Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number two. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. When you go to the sideline after chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points.
Okay.
But we also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily, though.
Back to throw. Knight. It's incomplete. Took a shot. Couldn't connect. Well, too much oomph. Too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, it was too much mustard.
They really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Off the play fake. Knight. They'll roll it out right. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose.
All right. I see how it is.
And out now comes Jacksonville as
I
they get
see
ready to go.
How it
certainly
is.
Want to avoid what they had to do
the
last
drive,
possession.
The
that was punt the football because this game is starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them. They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their
play. The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes.
Come on,
like how they've started the third quarter here. They force a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. The Jaguars on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third down and 12. Operating from the gun. Knight.
Good fire.
It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
We just keep the ball tight.
And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
Yes, I know for that.
The game this close, you gotta feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. Where Brandon Pace comes into play now, because they've got the advantage, they've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher.
And he can't get rid of it, he's taken down.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
The Jaguars on third down. Lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is 3rd and 14. He's going to look deep down the field.
And he caught him. You see?
He takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A very nice pick up of 33 yards.
And that was scary, but we got it. We got it.
Tell you what, though, a one-handed grab of that length. Talk about giving your team a little.
There you go.
Big time. I mean, everyone's gonna be
go tight end. Go. 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 Go tight end. Go.
It's gonna be tough to get him down. Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. Look at the throw. Knight.
What the heck, guys?
There, bringing up second down.
That's it, baby.
Can I?
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down.
Four down.
Off play action. hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball.
Go tight end.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
All right, kick another field goal. Excuse me.
And out now comes
Jacksonville. Excuse me.
Detroit! And last time able to get three. It's not what they want. They wanted six, but they got to win something. They must get something out of it.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball.
Okay, we just need to get close.
Throwing again on second and ten. Knight going deep for Moncrief. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground and it brings up third.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
Moncrief.
Big play coming up. Here's third and ten.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 36. And he will score. Touchdown, Indianapolis.
Okay, cool. Cool beans. Cool beans. Cool. I thought you had it, bro.
But it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes officials just say, let him play. Kind of like your mom used to with you and your brothers. Just take the broom tee and send you out to the backyard until you settle yourselves.
I like that. Yeah, there was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Wow. Being able to play a zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands. Guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Have a mother in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the third down.
And that will be incomplete as well.
Game over, guys. That was a good game. Coach is giving us another try.
Really? And now comes Jacksonville really? As they get ready to go. These guys had to punt their last possession.
Yeah, they did.
Too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep
it. Did he catch it?
A lot of times the punter goes to his side and puts on sweat. No,
he dropped it.
Wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
He dropped it.
Right at scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
To throw again, Knight, and the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete, so it can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're gonna get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual
Detroit!
Player.
Detroit!
No chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Back to throw, Knight, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
And I think we'll probably see him go for it here on fourth down. No reason not to.
1 second, guys. All right, we're back.
They have to try and make something good happen.
Gone, gone!
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And
damn.
Incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining.
And game's over. Nope, the game is still alive. Why is this game still going?
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to
I don't understand. Why is this game still freaking going? Like, can't be football.
Now the Jags are moving quickly in the hurry up.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Pretty nice gain on the scramble. Gets him 12 yards. Counting down to 30 seconds remaining.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Going right side here, and that's...
I don't have anything else.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down. Off the bootleg. Knight, nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Come on, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up.
And they are able to spike it. Gotta get close, but 2 seconds left on the clock.
That's the end of the game, guys.
Charles, we saw a lot.
Our defense played all right. An offense, not so good.
They've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do.
Andrew Luck was on fire. That's all I got to say. Is Andrew Luck was on fire. Alright guys, that's the end of this episode. If you guys enjoyed, catch you guys in the next episode against the Tennessee Titans. I'm out. Peace.